By Kathleen Ronayne, the Associated Press. California Governor Gavin Newsom and lawmakers have reached a spending deal on small business grants, stimulus checks for individuals and housing for farmworkers infected by the coronavirus, Newsom said Wednesday. It includes a fresh $24 million for a program that puts farm and food processing workers up in hotels if they contract the virus and have no place to isolate, Newsom said as he spoke at a community vaccination clinic in the Coachella Valley, a region that's home to many farmworkers. "It's candidly been underutilized, and we recognize that," Newsom said of the farmworker housing program. "And the purpose of this new appropriation is to maximize its effectiveness." Newsom and lawmakers released a joint statement with details on the other spending items, including money for grants of $5,000 to $25,000 for small businesses, nonprofits, and cultural centers. The deal will also cover Newsom's proposed stimulus plan to give a $600 one-time payment to low-income Californians. The governor's visit to the Coachella Valley was his latest stop in a tour around the state to highlight vaccination efforts as California's virus numbers continue to improve. Local and county governments have teamed up with nonprofits and community groups in the valley to vaccinate farmworkers and at-risk populations. Details of the stimulus package include 2 years of fee relief that can range annually from $455 to $1,235 for roughly 59,000 restaurants and bars licensed through the state's Department of Alcoholic Beverage Control. The deal also includes fee relief for more than 600,000 barbering and cosmetology individuals and businesses licensed through the Department of Consumer Affairs. More than $400 million in new federal funds will provide stipends of $525 per enrolled child for all state-subsidized child care and preschool providers serving approximately 400,000 children statewide. The new funding extends care for children of essential workers through June 2022. That money also increased access to subsidized child care for more than 8,000 children of essential workers and at-risk children, who are not currently served in the system, through June 2022. An additional $24 million will toward financial assistance and services through Housing for the Harvest, a program providing support for agricultural workers who have to quarantine due to COVID-19. The agreement also provides a combined $35 million for food banks and diapers. An additional $100 million in emergency financial aid will to qualifying low-income students carrying six or more units, with award amounts to be determined locally and made available by early April. The deal also provides $20 million to re-engage students who have either left their community college studies because of the pandemic or to engage students at risk of leaving.